even middens high up here, 10, 20 metres above the water. And just gets better as we walk around. I think we missed all this last time. Checking our tray pots, and up there we go to Mount Amos, and the other one is only a few hundred metres high. Now we're just climbing up this new walkway to the lighthouse. And we were just around in that next far bay. Not this one here. We could look around and see this lump. This looks like a little rocky lighthouse. And there's Wine Glass Bay out behind it. There's a guy just who left the sleepy bay. He's going out to check his tray pots. A little bit choppy out there now. That's a fabulous bit of coastline, and this walkway enhances the view somewhat. Makes it very easy. It just follows around on the sheltered side of the hill. Some of the better views actually before you get to the lookout. usual windy lighthouse, so it's a bit boring this one. This is about the best position. This is a large Moulting lagoon where all the swans live, and cygnets molt. 10 bands of up to 70 to 80 people used to harvest oysters and mussels. We just bought our kilo of mussels down the road at the mussel oyster farm. I've got a dozen oysters as well, but the tours were going to cost $30 a head, and they're booked out tomorrow. So we thought we'd come and look at swans. Swans everywhere, and further up the coast where they shoot them, they have hides. So the shooters hide and shoot. Game down there. You can see little black boxes. I should have brought the tripod. If I'm lucky, I'll get Isaac's Point on the friendly beaches with a bit of sunshine on it. That's looking south down the friendly beaches to the lighthouse and Mount Amos, etc. The three peaks of Freycinet. Just get our binoculars out and we can have a look at the lighthouse, whether we'll be able to see it on the TV, on the video, is another thing. Blowing a gale up here. It's all been part of the Freycinet National Park since 1992. The campground is down near the rocks. We might have a little squeeze down. The sun's just come out again. It's not sunny where we are. It's a lovely coastline. We spoke to the ranger who was coming to pick up rubbish from the campers. There's half a dozen bins swamped empty. Now the sun's come out. Sun's gone out again. Mary's just collecting some sand. There's a lovely start of a sand pit. A few rocks. More sand like we collected. Oh, the rock just missed a nice wave then. Passed up over that point.
Come over here, back here, because there's the group.
And a lovely collection of camp spots amongst the trees. Watch the lot of waves crashing over this one here. We spend the evening here. Now it's after much past five. The sun has just gone out. We've come along several miles of windy track. A blowout area on the beach. Looks like a very old launching spot. Big large muddy area. You can see the sun's gone behind a large cloud.
It's got cold.
Nobody else around. I think we've got several miles of beach to ourselves. Back home now for dinner with our cold clay mussels. We're just tossing them here and they're starting to open. They are very fresh and we've had our dozen oysters. Our little Springvale Chardonnay from nearby. I might recommend it to the element. sunset 10 minutes ago. That yummy? Been chatting to an old couple who've been on the road for a few weeks. They've got booked Campsites Australia from Queensland. And it's got all these little spots on it. And this is Swan Creek or something on the left, looking across to the peninsula. It comes from across at Swansea. On the mainland there.
It's a bit.
And that's the end of the peninsula. And here's the sooty.
Oh, there he goes.
The sooty thingo. Midden with your old oysters, layers and layers of occupation right up to the campsites. There's some great camping down there. Now driven up around and we're up here looking across the lots of vineyards. Vineyards and olive groves. Swansea, and two out of three of the coffee shops are closed.
And the other one's full up.
We camped down there 15 years ago over the edge near the water.
Return 1.8 kilometers.
Yeah. A couple of hours ago, we were way along there in the howling gale. The wind's coming up from the south, up to Oyster Bay.
They're a bit damp.
Are they? You get wet stripes on your bottom.
Oh.
Any fish jumping? It's ripe for redevelopment. Hotel. For sale. And there's the old stables. Old log split timber. There's the old tables. Just changed batteries then. A few more, circa 1840. And all the locals got together. And for their memorials. So it goes on. Two telephones here. Ready to go and set up camp.
Go on again. Is that right? What did you guys say? 20 seconds? Is it 20 seconds?
Come back. Yeah, it's 20 seconds today.
A calendar and thing.
Calendar as well.
Yeah. See the thing here.
Oh, okay.
The dot in the middle. Yeah. See the dot?
All right.
You rotate it until the dot is as close as you can get it to the
clever bit of.
Great.
Oh, that's the month of transit there.
Yeah, and then you cut. No, it's not. And then that's the calendar. Okay, so it's lighting up that. And
it is
when
now.
I counted, 19th.
Where's the time of day?
Here.
Down there.
Mm. But that's not right.
The seat.
Yeah, you do it by.
And you sit in it and drive it.
But you drive it.
What a great invention.
Yeah. Fabulous. But I've been waiting and waiting and waiting. That's the first time the sun's been bright enough to cast a shadow.
So you sit here and drive it and turn it round, and when you line up the little dot.
Waited for half an hour for the sun to
come
out.
Gives you the time of day there.
And that gives you the days you add the little, count the dots. But it's a day out. I've got the 20th, the 5:15.
Well, then your daylight saving you have to think about.
5:15 daylight saving. Well, it's not, that's the trouble. It's reading the right time.
Yeah.
So it's an hour out.
And it's very comfortable to sit on, even.
Yeah. Thurston Bradley's manufacturing.
Not far from Zepp's Cap, so we got the altitude above sea level as well.